Hello everyone, very good morning to all. Can you please confirm me whether I am visible or not? Visible, streaming is started, clear, without any disturbance, no issues, no background and voice echo, everything is clear. Hello Sushil Kumar, Cutie, Nalini Sharma, Sushil, Asati, Muskan, Srivastav, Vibha Shukla, Nalini Sharma, Revati, Gopal Krishnan. Everyone, good morning, good morning. Hello, we'll start. Information and Communication Technology, single liners we are going to take up in this session. From 10 a.m. to 11 will be there. 1 hour session it is. Information and Communication Technology from the paper 1, and as per the Unacademy Plus is concerned, Ignite batch for the paper 1 which is starting from the 1st of August, and Engage batch for the Commerce December 2020 starting from the same date, 1st of August. So on 1st of August we are starting two batches in my profile and in Niharika ma'am profile. And if you look at the total, Unacademy Plus is having these many batch courses which will be starting from the 1st of August itself. From the 1st of August itself, various commerce and paper 1, English medium, we are going to take up a Hindi medium, accomplished batch is there, and commerce, we are having two Hindi batches and one English batch, management batch is there for English and Hindi, and political science, computer science, economics, so many subjects are there which is starting. If you take one subscription which will be access to all live sessions of all batches, all educator courses, there is no restriction on it. And use my referral code Shiva Udnala to get 10% off on the subscription. Next, single liner that I am starting. What is Ignite and Engage batch? Ignite and Engage batch. Hello Commerce, Dimple, Rupa Pandey, Shubhashri, Minathi Biswal, Devati Muniyappa. Ignite is nothing but a burning. And Engage is nothing but create an interest in the studies. In that way, the meaning is given. So, Ignite is for the paper 1 and Engage for the Ignite your JRF dream by engaging in the studies is the motto of the batch courses. Right? I hope Hina Jain is clear with the meanings. Look at first singular error of the ICT. First singular error of the ICT. The output quality of a printer is measured by the dots per inch, DPI, dots per inch. Good morning, Satpura, Satpura Das. Hello, MOU Sarkar, MOU Sarkar, wow, okay. Dots per inch is the output quality of a printer measurement. Next, bug denotes. What do you mean by bug? Bug in any computer, bug is generally, as per the dictionary itself, it is treated as an error. Bug is general meaning error. So bug denotes an error in the computer program. If any errors that we faced an error, which is a try again will be there. That means something bug is there inside the programming language, so that it is creating error again and again. Next, a smaller text. The renewal subscription is allowed. Your all PDF given on the screen. No. Hello, Jayashree. Ram Kumar Aluwala. Good morning to everyone. Look at a smaller text started on user's computer by some website in order to recognize and keep a track of user's preference is called as a cookie. User's preference is called as a cookie. Cookie is nothing but history. Just. Your history, in your history, whatever you are browsing on that browser or by going through with the website, the browser will be remembering your past history to make it available easily. As and when you want again, you want to visit to that website, the cookies will help you to remember the preferences made by the user. Keeping a track of the user preference is called as a cookie. Next, .wav and .wmu, these are the audio formats, and .mp4 and .mov, dot mov. These are coming under the video format. This is an audio and this is an video. Hello, chilled study. Good morning, Swati Sinha. Good morning, Rajput. Hello, Dina Jain. I think I gave an answer in the WhatsApp also to you. Look at over here. Point number 5. In a computer, if 8 bits are used to specify the address in a memory, the total number of addresses will be 256. Total number of maximum addresses will be 256. And minimum will be 8 bits are used to specify the address in a memory. But total number of addresses in any memory, it will be having maximum 256. Next, this is an most important repeated previous year question. WYI, WYS and WYG. WYSI, WYG. What you see is what you get. This is related to printer output. Printer output. WYS, IWYG. Right? Printer output will be shown on the desktop or while giving a printing. It is coming on the pages. That is whatever you are seeing on the screen, it will be coming as an output in the printer form, which is a physical or hard copy. I don't have your number. Then who is this Hina Jain? I hope the Hina Jain is same. Hina Jain, I believe Hina Jain, both that Hina Jain and you both are same, I am assuming. Hello Kavyashree and Preeti Kandan. Look at a software that you can download for free, but you have to pay continue to use it after a trial period called as a shareware. Shareware, did you heard about this shareware, which is a cloud storage? I can say cloud storage is a storage after certain period of 7 days or else at 1 month trial period will be given. After the trial period, you have to subscribe or you have to make a payment to that use that shareware. So initially it will be for free or downloading for free, but you have to continue after the trial period by making a payment only. Next, Swayam is a website. Good morning Subrata and Raghav B. Look at here. Swayam study world of action learning for young aspiring minds. Swayam is an study world of, it is an e-learning platform which is having a 9 coordinators. We have to give the content and give the lectures 9 coordinators under the Swayam, and it will be working on a 3 cardinal principle: equity, access, and what is the other one? Access, equity, and third principle of the Swayam. First principle is equity and access. Third one. I'm following you on YouTube. Willing to take the subscription? Yes, you can contact me. Obviously the number is scrolling down below, but it is not applicable for renewal. You can use my code renewal for the 10% discount. Exactly, quality, EAQ, that is quality, is the third principle. Now a group access to digital technology and another group lacks of access to it will cause a disparity known as digital divide. Now we are in the towns and we are having an internet connectivity. We are able to watch whatever coming on the online. But think about the rural background people, rural background students. So whether they are able to contact to the use of information communication technology or is digital technology like you are using. You are using just like it is like a cakewalk for you. But for them, they have to come to the nearest areas where there is a facility of internet connection. Otherwise they can't able to convert. So here group 1, which is a rural. Group 2 is an which is a town, where all facilities are available, where no facilities are available. The difference between both groups is called as a digital divide. Here, because of the digital technology only, we are making a division. That will be called as a digital divide. Next one will be RAM is one of the computer component is fastest in terms of a speed of access. Now, if at all you wanted to identify the speed of the if the RAM is more, your computer or laptop speed is more. RAM will decide your speed of the computer. The more the higher the RAM, faster the speed. Right? Higher the RAM, the speed is also much faster. Next, Wiki is a system that allows a collaborative modification of its content and structure directly from the web browser. Wikipedia, you know, right? Wikipedia. The moment that you search anything in the Google, the first thing that you will show is Wikipedia website only, which will be giving and content that you are searching for. That means anyone can modify easily or can insert the new data or update the data in the Wiki website. That is Wikipedia website. It is an collaborative. That means group modification of the content there in the Wiki can be done structurally by using a web browser called as an Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, anything. Because Wiki is a website where every user can provide the content in that or modify the content in the Wiki website. Good morning, Amanpreet Kaur. Next one is spyware. What do you mean by spyware? Spyware is related to antivirus software, right? Spyware, that means someone is seeing you in like we can say it is like a CC camera. It aims to gather the information about a person without his or her knowledge, and that may send such information to another entity. Like if spyware software is installed in your computer, then that will be taking secret data from your, or else very confidential data that is taking from your computer and transferring it to other organizations like that will be called as a spyware. Simple terminology. Next, what is VLE? Virtual Learning Environment. Full form is Virtual Learning Environment. That is what now we are. We are in a virtual learning environment. We are learning like it is, you take an Academy Plus platform, an Academy Free platform, and now in a YouTube opt for educational purpose, all are coming under the virtual learning environment. We are using the internet to connect each other. Next, next will be 14th one. WORM is a virus that can be transferred from one computer to another computer. See, here spyware is a software that will be installed in your computer and to gather any type of information about a personal information mainly. And WORM is also one type of virus, but it is transferred from one computer to another computer even without a user involvement also. Without user involvement also, the possibility of transferring from one computer to another computer will be there. Next, Microsoft Windows is an example of proprietary software. That means proprietary software is nothing but it is ownership. Ownership is there only with regard to the Microsoft Windows operating system. That ownership is only exclusively owned by the Microsoft company, which is Bill Gates, right? Now, no one can claim the ownership of the Microsoft Windows, that is operating system. Next, local area network. What is local area network? LAN is within the building or else within the two buildings. Within building. Next, MAN is metropolitan area network. Metropolitan area network. Next, wide area network. This is within the city and this is within the geographical area. Whatever the area, big area, much wider. Wide is defining a broader in sense, right? Next, example of spyware, you can take any software which is injecting, virus into your computer. Suppose some software will be having an atom that is infected by the virus itself. Though if you install those type of software, then the hackers might be installed a patch in it. Suppose whatever you are using a software, you are using a CAM scanner. Usually previous 6 months back, CAM scanner is having a one bug. Advertisement spy was inserted in that. So if you install that, it will be taking a personal information. 6 months back, the CAM scanner has been, it was an issue with the CAM scanner. After report, the bug has been removed. So at that time, it is not safer to the users to use that software. So because virus is inserted in it is taking your confidential or personal data to use it for some unauthorized purpose. That will be called as a spyware, we can say. Hello Shipra Arora. Next, LCD. LCD stands for LCD. Light compact display. Is it correct? Tell me first. Is it correct? Light compact display. I'm waiting for your response. Look at here. This is called as a liquid crystal display. Liquid crystal display. Liquefied is wrong. Liquefied is wrong, I think. Now look at phishing. What do you mean by phishing? Phishing is also coming under the virus only, or else taking some sensitive information. Attempt to acquire sensitive information for a malicious reasons and mass coordinating the trustworthy entity as a trustworthy entity. Look at here. Phishing can be done by the hackers. If at all any person wanted to hack your computer, he is an hacker computer. If at all they wanted to phish your computer, that means hack your computer because they want sensitive information, which is your personal information. In such case, they will hack your computer and they will take it. They will take the sensitive information which is required generally for the banking transaction. To loot the money, banking transaction, this can be done. Next one will be steal the information. Exactly. Next, spreadsheet. Spreadsheet is used to automatic calculation for preparing a budget. Not only for preparing a budget. Do you know about MS Word? MS Word. So the spreadsheet is same as referred as an MS Word or MS Excel, which is mainly for the purpose of representing the data. Representing or presenting the data. Calculations also can be done in the Excel. Automatic calculation can be done. One of the best example of the spreadsheet in Microsoft is that MS Excel is the best example. MS Word or MS Excel. Next, look at here. Spamming. What do you mean by spamming? In your emailing, one of the folder on the left side corner, you can see one of the option is spam folder. If mail is not received, the sender will inform us, please check spam folder also. That means advertising or else unsolicited messages, irritating messages, which are bug messages, which are error messages, which are not safer, those will be directly going into the spam folder. Which is like a mainly advertising messages will be there. Like if you are registered your phone number or your mail with a bank. Bank will be sending daily advertisement messages that will be storing or sending it to a spam only. An academy also sending advertisement mails to you. That is also sometimes you can see on the spam, but majority cases it will be coming on the promotional tab. Next, RAM is a volatile memory and the amount of RAM in a computer can affect its performance. Correct or not? Because RAM is a mechanism mainly for the purpose of speed. So more the RAM, fast the speed will be there. In the same way, amount of RAM in a computer can affect its performance because speed is decided by the RAM. Next, Bluetooth is a wireless technology which can use to connect headset to mobile phone. Now it is a very shortest distance or longer distance. Without any wire connection, very shorter in distance, we can connect two devices for transferring the files or for transferring anything. Next, we can't transfer internet via Bluetooth, right? Am I clear? we can't transfer like hotspot, we can't use Bluetooth. Hotspot is mainly for transferring the internet or data, or the Bluetooth only for the purpose of files like image files, video files, audio files. These files can be sent. Next, logic box, operating system control the peripheral and allocates the memory and the processor time. So whenever you are installing your operating system in the computer, whenever you are installing operating system OS, booting process can be done, right? Booting, you can experience the booting like shift plus F12, we need to type it. We need to type the F12 when it is restarting, then it will start booting. At that time it will ask the partition to divide. The C drive or as total hard disk memory that has to be divided into a different parts, and the processor time also fixed. Each and every allocation can be done when you are installing an operating system in your computer. Though that will be defined as an operating system. With the help of operating system, we can do this many things. Booting process, correct. Next one is logic bomb. What is logic bomb? Logic bomb is a malware. Again, it is a type of virus. Intentionally instituted into a software system that will set off a malicious function when specified conditions are met. Look at logic bomb is like a, I will explain with a diagram. Logic bomb. Now, suppose say so many were downloading a TikTok. In the TikTok, actually for earning purpose also, they used to give the banking details, right? Now, if any hacker wanted to steal the information of all the users of TikTok, what they can do? In the TikTok app itself or in the TikTok software itself, they will install a one bug or else patch. They will add this patch or bug to that TikTok app. Whoever is downloading or whoever is using that software is infected by this virus, because this virus is given or a malicious thing which is inserted by the hacker. Hacker will be getting each and every information of the users. That is how. Next, as I informed to everyone, Ignite batch for the paper 1 and Engage batch for the commerce December 2020 starting from the 1st of August. If at all you wanted to take an Academy Plus subscription, take. This is the right opportunity at the right time, because if it is starting in August, means it will go till 3 months, August to October it will go. 3 months programs, all these batches are 3 months program. And these two batches are exclusively only for the English people, and Hindi people also can attend because understandable level of English will be used. Anyone can attend these batches, and these are the other courses, other batches that are starting in Academy Plus. If you take one subscription, you will get access to all those batches as well as all individual courses of the educator. Now look at here, if you are taking any month, any plan, then you can use my referral code Shiva Odnala to not only get 10% discount, you will be getting these PDFs like a paper 1 topic wise previous year question, single liner PDF you will be getting, and a commerce study material PDF you are going to get. Next, my handwriting, where is my handwriting? Here. चाइना का फोन भी सब यूज कर रहे हैं. हाँ, इफ यू वांट टू शो द पेट्रियाटिज्म ना, डू यू हैव अ डे टू ब्रेक योर मोबाइल चाइना मोबाइल फोन्स? डू यू हैव अ डे? यू आर अनइंस्टॉलिंग इन योर मोबाइल एप्स. द मोबाइल एप्स गॉट अनइंस्टॉल्ड विच इज एज पर द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, बिकॉज दैट इज फॉर फ्री. बाई अनइंस्टॉलिंग यू विल नॉट गेट एनीथिंग, राइट? यू हैव अ डे टू ब्रेक योर मोबाइल? नो, राइट? बिकॉज इन्वेस्टमेंट हैज बीन मेड. You are not having that much there to break the mobile. So let it be. So the patriotism. We are all patriots of India. But the thing is, our amount also involved in it. Just for understanding purpose, you can easily relate the China example. Look at first generation computer. First generation computer, they used a vacuum tube, and the second generation computer used a transistor. Third generation integrated circuits, and fourth generation ultra large scale integrated microprocessor they used. Fifth generation, they were using artificial intelligence. I think this fourth generation is having VLSI and ULSI. Here, ultra large scale integrated softwares, or else artificial intelligence, mainly used in the fifth generation languages, fifth generation computers. AI. मैं अपो कौन अपो अपो फोन को थ्रो वाओ नाउ लुक एट हियर आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस डन कंप्यूटर प्रोग्राम दैट स्प्रेड्स बाय इंसर्टिंग ए कॉपीज इटसेल्फ नाउ इन योर कंप्यूटर जनरल यू विल गेट दिस ऑप्शन ऑटोमेटिकली समटाइम्स कॉपी नंबर 1 कॉपी नंबर 2 कॉपी नंबर 3 कॉपी one file getting duplicated. What does that mean? One file getting duplicated. What is the meaning of that? That means some virus has been infected or some virus has been inserted in your computer. Your computer has a virus. You need to use the antivirus, then only those problem will be solved. So it is duplicating the copies. How much percent current affairs? Only maximum one question that you can expect from the current affairs, or else 2. Next, RGB, or else RBG, or else BRG, red, green, blue. In audio video compression, it stands for RGB, red, green, blue. It is used for the purpose of AV, audio and video compression purpose. You are getting the color TV, that means LED, LCD and color TVs. That means in your TVs or in your computer, whenever you are seeing a color, means RGB is installed in your computer for showing a digital display, like a color form of displays. Next, web browsers are Internet Explorers, Mozilla Firefox. Next, Google Chrome, Safari, Opera are coming under the web browsers. Now, HTML, that is hypertext markup language, is used to create the web pages. For creating a web pages, HTML will be used. For creating a web pages, like web page is nothing but www.unacademy.com is there. Home button will be there, and courses button will be there, subscription button. These are the different pages in the website. For creating these web pages, the HTML coding can be done, which is abbreviated as an hypertext markup language. Next, JPEG. JPEG is used to compress the images. See, this is a format of the images. Now, if at all you wanted to convert anything in the form of images, you have to convert either in the PNG form, or else JPEG, various formats for the images will be there. Those are JPEG and format for the image. Next, Yahoo and Google are coming under the search engines, not a web browsers. That means in the web browser you will be typing this search engine, right? With the use of web browsers only you will be going to search. You are going to use the search engines with the use of web browser, or else in the web browsers only you are using the search engines, like Yahoo and Google. Web browser is a software which is an application software that in that you can use the search engine to get the information in any form. All are PYQs only, because PYQs are converted into a single liners to for a quick revision purpose. Hello Shivali Bhagat. Now, what are the two main component of a CPU? One is control unit, second one is arithmetic logic unit. Control unit is controlling the entire activity of the computer. Next, arithmetic logic unit is for the calculation purpose. Calculation for performing the arithmetical calculations. Next, AICIIT. Look at AASCII stands for American Standard Code for Information and Interchange. American Standard Code for Information Interchange is the abbreviation of the AASCII. Net exam kab hoga? Zubair Ali. Net exam kab hoga? Probably based on the tentative announcement made by the CSIR HRD. Director General, I think, of the HRD CSIR. As per their tweet, CSIR is going to held in the November 2nd week or 1st week. So if that is going to true, then our UGC net also 1 or more week less 1 week before or 1 week later. It might be. That is what the simple expectation, but I am not sure. Now EBCDIL, that is extended binary coded decimal interchange. Extended binary code decimal interchange. Look at here, there are three translators. One is assembler, second one is interpreter, third one is compiler. What is assembler? Assembler converts assembly language into a machine language. Assembly language to machine language. Now second one, interpreter, converts high level language into a machine level language. This is high level language into a machine level languages. One at a time or line by line will be there. Next, compiler is having a high level language into a machine level language. That means high level language to machine level language at a time, not one by one line. It is at a time total entire data is changing into the machine language. That will be a compiler. Now out of the three, which is fastest in nature? Assembler, interpreter, compiler, which is fast translating into the other language? Tell me. Compiler is fast translating into the other language. Now out of the three translators, compiler is fast because at a time it is translating high level language into a machine level language at one go, whereas interpreter is line by line or else one at a time it will be going. Assembler is not used for the high level to machine language, it is for the assembly language to machine language assembler conversion can be used. Done. Now here if you look at, shall I take this opportunity to explain about the bits, the binary to decimal, decimal to binary? Shall I? Now, look at over here. Bit is generally denoted in the binary form, that is 0 or 1 will be there. 1 byte is equal to 8 bits. 1 byte is equal to 8 bits and 4 bits is equal to 1 nibble, right? And 1 byte is equal to 8 bits. That equal to 2 nibbles is equal to 1 byte, right? 2 nibbles is equal to 1 byte. 4 bit is equal to 1 nibble. 2 nibbles is equal to 1 byte. That means 1 byte is equal to 8 bits, we can say. Now 1 KB is equal to 1024 bytes, which is equal to 2 power 10. Next, megabyte, MB is equal to 1024 KB, that is kilobyte, which is equal to 2 power 20 bytes. And gigabytes is equal to 1024 megabytes, that is MB, which is equal to 2 power 30. And terabyte, 1024 gigabytes, which is 2 power 40. And petabyte, exabyte, yottabyte, those are there, various things. Next, file extension. file extension, look at here, these are repetitive in nature. Kindly, any one file extension is repeatedly asking in the examination. Look at carefully, whenever you are saving an audio file in your computer, the name of the file like class 1, this is a file name. The name of the file will be saved in the form of WAV or else MP3 or else these are the two general audio versions. For audio purpose, your file is getting saved in the WAV or else MP3 in your mobile phone also. In your mobile phone also, you can see for the audio purpose, you will be having a file extension. File extension is nothing but the name or else a format in which the file has been saved. And next, if you look at whenever you are saving a Microsoft Word document, the document presentation is the name. That presentation dot DOC or else DOCX is the saved format. DOC or DOCX is indicating, yes, your file is saved in the form of MS Word. That is indicating which is a text executable form, a Microsoft Word. Next, notepad files. The moment that you open the notepad, if you look at over here, notepad, if at all you want to save this notepad file, I typed something on the notepad. Now, if at all you wanted to save this, it will be saving as TXT. You can see, look at here, TXT is there, dot TXT. Automatically, it is getting saved in the form of dot TXT. Look at here, it is visible, clearly visible, right? Now, that means for notepad files, TXT is the extension that we'll be using it. Next, PPT. The moment that you are saving a presentation in the MS PowerPoint, that is Microsoft Office PowerPoint, if you are using, your file will be saved with a name as well as the extension of the PPT. The moment that you see PPT on the last of the name of that file, that means that file is in the form of PPT MS Office. Next, images dot JPG. The every image that you take it, for each image in your mobile also, you can see JPG image number 1, image number 2, image number 1 dot JPG, image number 2 dot JPG. Like that, you can see those JPGs indicating it is there in the image format. Next, Excel. So PowerPoint is done, MS Word is done in the form of Excel. Forever you are, if at all your data is saved in the MS Excel form, then the name of the file is indicating by name dot Excel. Like that, it will be XLS. That means the moment that you see XLS means it is saved in the form of Excel. Saved in the form of Excel, right? These are the different file extensions which are repeating in the examination in one shot, you can see. WAV and .mp3 is for the sound or audio files. .docx is for Word. .txt is for the notepad files. .ppt is for the PowerPoint. .jp is for the images. .xls is for the Excel. Next look at HTTP. It is a protocol that supports a linking from one web page to another web page. Now look at here, if I write one website example, http://www.anacademy.com. That means this is indicating, this is a protocol which supports a linking from one web page to another web page. Hypertext transfer protocol. I explained that is already done. Now, HTTP is a protocol which is accessing or linking one page to another web page. If at all you want to go to this website, yes, it will take you through. And from the website inside, you want to move from home page to subscription page or else courses page or else educator profile page. Like that you are going means it is giving or it is giving an access or it is allowing because of the HTTP protocol is present in the web browser in that is why you can able to access the each and every page. If this is not present in the web browser or in that link, then you can't able to access any page there in the website. Done. HTTPS is for the secure. Whenever the banking transactions are happening, HTTPS will be coming. HTTPS is nothing but S stands for secured over here. S stands for secured. Whenever you are doing a OTP transaction or internet banking transaction or more confidential website that you are entering, then they will be showing a HTTPS. Next, domain name. Now the domain name. Look at here. The best example that I can provide for each and everything is Amazon.com. Is a commercial website, right? Commercial website. So .com is for the commercial institute or commercial organization. Nowadays .com is for all, not only for the commercial purpose. So many other entities also using, not only profit making entities, so many other entities also using .com version, .com domain I can say. And .edu, .edu for the purpose of educational institutions only. Suppose igno.edu, igno.edu, and Delhi University, du.com.edu, delhiuniversity.edu. That means those are educational institutions or university which are using the .edu, .edu. Next, .gov, government website, mhrd.gov.in, mhrd.gov.in. Next one is military sites, military site, indianmilitary.mil, indianmilitary.mil. Suppose assume Indian military or else armed forces and itbp.mil. That means Indo-Tibetan border force will be there. Those are coming under the military website, which is for the defense purpose mainly, defense field. Next, .net is a gateway or administrative host. .net is a gateway or administrative host, generally network providers like Hathaway.net, which is a broadband providers or a network providers or host, mainly I can say godaddy.com it is, and godaddy.net will be there. So many other things who are having a gateway and administrative of the network system total. And .org for the private organization or non-profit organization, icai.org, Institute of Chartered Accountants of India.org, is coming under the private organization. Done. I don't know Hindi, but my English is understandable, which is very low. Now the domains are done. Next, go to the next part. Look at over here. Bheem is an Bharat interface for money developed by the National Payment Corporation of India. Whether Bheem is a separate app or else it is a separate app of the government, right? For making a digital transaction via UPI. Unified Payment Interface. That now you are using in a phone pay and other Google Pay also. Next, a modern electric computer is a machine that is meant for the input, storage and manipulation and outputting the data. Look at over here. This is electronic computer is a machine that is meant for input and storage and manipulation and outputting of the data. Modern electronic computer, they are referring, giving a definition, not only for storing up, it is for the processing also. That I can say processing is missed out, it is for the processing also, because with the process only you can give the input and store and manipulation, anything can be done. So processing is the main meaning or the definition of the modern electric computer. Also processing will be coming under them. any problem that if the sir don't know Hindi? Yes, Bina. I told you already that I don't know. Now look at here. 45. Data is not a main component of the computer. Now here I want to make data and information relationship. Data and information. Look at. Data is an raw form. And it is a modified or purified form. From the data, you will be getting a purified form of the information. This is a raw data which is available like anything. It is a zigzag. From that, if you are making any conclusion or purifying, that one is called as an information. Now, all data can be an information, cannot be an information. All data cannot be an information. But all information can be called as an. All information can be an data. All information can be an data. Bina, you are understanding my explanation, right, Bina? Good morning, Amandeep. You are understanding my explanation. I am going very slow. Intentionally, I am going very slow. Not much zigzag. Then task is done. Don't feel it as a Hindi medium. Remove that fear in the mind. There is no issue in it. Now, data is an. All data cannot be an information, but all information can be a data. Look at. Data is not a main component of the computer. Only information will be coming under there. Next. Look at here, 46th one. The brain of the any computer is CPU. And CPU will be having a control unit, arithmetic logic unit, and as well as the registers also. Registers. Next, CPU is a combination of the arithmetic logic or a control unit. CPU is a combination of arithmetic logic or a control unit. Next. Max frame is not a computer classification, because mainframe computers that were used in a big insurance and banking companies, but max frame is not a computer type. It is separate. Max frame is not a computer type. It is not coming under here. Next, the computer that work on a continuous data are called as an analog computer. We have two computers, that is digital and analog. And analog computers are one-way communication, or only one-way signals will be there. Analog, one-way signals will be there in the analog computers. Next, digital, two-way will be there. The types of digital computers will be supercomputer, mainframe computer, and microcomputer, mini computer. These are coming under the digital computers. Digital computers, the types of computers if you look at. And we are having analog computer, a digital computer, main classification. Under that, digital, supercomputer, mainframe computer, mini computer, microcomputer. Four classifications. Done. Right. Okay, no issue. Chalo, come back. Now here you can see, this is my referral code. You can use it for the subscription purpose. Let us go into the another 10. Because we are having 10 minutes. Why to waste the time? We'll do 10 more single lines. Look at. Microcomputer is a type of computer on the basis of the size. Classification I told you, microcomputer is a type of computer which is classified on the basis of size, and palm top is a computer that is smallest in the size. Palm top is nothing but which you can operate, very mini computer in the size, like you can experience this much A 15.6 is a normal laptop, but a compute the laptop can be very much minimum also, like a 12 inches laptops, mini laptops will be there, which is a very size is very smaller in nature. Next, hybrid computer is resembles both digital as well as analog computer. This is a digital as well as analog computer. And analog computer, the examples of hybrid computer. Can anyone give the example of the hybrid computer? Can anyone give the example of the hybrid computer? Washing machine. Washing machine is the best one. Next, second example for the hybrid computer is X-ray in the hospital, ECG equipment in the hospitals, and big equipment that will be used in the banking also. Those are also coming under the hybrid computers. Next, to monitor the ICU patients, they will be having a different thing, which is taking digital and analog computer features also. That equipments are coming under the hybrid computer. Now, assembly language started to be used from the second generation of the computer. We know very well, second generation is an assembly language. Third and fourth generations are machine languages, and fifth generation is using artificial intelligence language, right? Next, first level is machine language, second level is assembly language, third and fourth levels are high level languages, and fifth level are coming under the artificial intelligence. Look, artificial intelligence is associated with the fifth generation. Just now I told you, fifth generation is of computer is still under development, because still we can't get a full-fledged form of the artificial intelligence computers in India. Now, still, to be frank, we are in the fourth generation use computer only. We are using fourth generation computers, not fifth generation. Very rarely, only scientific institutions or else research organizations are using mainly this fifth generation, which are artificial intelligence computers. Next, LAN type of network commonly used in a college lab environment, right? The college lab is treated as a LAN. Best example of that, because within one room you will be having a so many computer, which is taking one cable or one host or one that will be there, one, what I can say, that will be a router will be there, one router will be giving an supply of internet facility to so many computer within that room. So, college lab is the best example for the LAN type of environment within that building. Next, WAN is a type of environment commonly used in the international organization. Wide area network, that means very bigger scope. Like Government of India introduced Connect India. Connect India is in the universities generally. But as per that digital India, so many smart cities came into picture. Now, in order to implement the smart cities, what the Government of India is doing? Government of India is doing one main connection, main host will be there. From there only it is providing internet facility to so many areas in that smart city, in that particular city. From my state, that Warangal is elected for the smart city initiative by the Government of India. Now in Warangal, what they thought is, they are using a WAN type of network, which is to give entire in that particular area, entire in that city, which is also coming under the MAN also sometime, because Metropolitan Area Network is a smart city initiative. Now WAN is a very bigger level. Geographical area is much bigger than the MAN also. Bina Bhati, overall the world or wide? It is wide. Wide area network, mainly used in the international organization, they are saying. Look at, modem is not a transmission medium. Then what is a modem? Modem full form is modulator and demodulator, right? Modulator and demodulator is the modem definition. Modulator and demodulator, which is mainly for the purpose of getting the internet connectivity, which is a wireless one. Next, for data transfer also we can insert the modem. Then modem is not a transmission medium, but it is transferring a data, and internet also. From that, if you insert the SIM or data in that modem, then you will be getting an access to the internet. Now, communication software are a protocol, and communication hardware is required to communicate between the computer. If at all you wanted to access to the software, any software. Now I am using a OneNote Windows 10. It is a software. So there is a protocol that is required. And for communicating in the hardware, you should require a two computer. Communication hardware is required to communicate between the two computer. Next, internet initially initial development was supported by the ARPANET. What is ARPANET full form? May I know the ARPANET full form? ARPANET full form is most important. What happened? I'm not getting any reply. ARPANET full form. Advanced research projects. Correct. Advanced Research Project Agency Network. This is how the computer has been started. Internet has been started. ARPANET, Advanced Research Project Agency Network. With this only the development of the computer came into picture. Development of the internet, not the computer. Internet initial development has been started with the Advanced Research Project Agency Network, that is ARPANET. Then Advanced Research Projects Agency Network. Done. Super. Now that's all for the day. Right, 60 we have done. Now in tomorrow session at 1 p.m. of YouTube only, we have tomorrow 11 a.m. at An Academy free platform, top 5 important repeated topics in the examination. Those paper 1, 5 topics I am going to discuss at 11 a.m., 11 to 12. And again at 1 p.m. this same ICT I will be resuming again. At 1 p.m. same ICT from the 61 to up to complete, we will do the at 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. Right? Tomorrow, this is the schedule for tomorrow free session, 11 a.m. and 1 p.m. 11 a.m. catch me in the An Academy free platform and 1 p.m. in the same YouTube live. If at all you are joining in my Telegram channel, you will be getting an update about the my sessions. Commerce Adda UGC Net is my Telegram channel. You can just search it in the Telegram. You will get the channel. Join over there. You will get the information as and when I post it out. My paper 2 is commerce, and this is my referral code Shiva Udnala. You can use it for An Academy Plus platform, 10% discount purpose. Two batches are going to start under my profile, and various batches are going to start in An Academy platform. You can take advantage of this because exam is going to held for sure in the November or else December max. If you can complete within these 3 months, the syllabus will get completed. So it is better for you only if you take the subscription on August 1st itself, because all batches are going to start on August 1st. One subscription which will be giving an access to all these batches and all educator live sessions. Thank you so much. Bye bye to all. Yes. Thank you. Kindly hit the like button if you didn't hit. Hit the like button. If you like the session and if you want to motivate us, just hit the like button so that we'll be getting motivated to upload or come up with more types of marathons. Thank you. Bye-bye.